Hello and welcome to Forever Rugby on Forever Sports. And we have an interesting update with the Currie Cup hanging in the balance for this year and the future of South African rugby with it, I suppose, to a certain degree, in terms of the domestic structure and the domestic seasons and what the Currie Cup might or might not become in the coming years, with it potentially having to be moved out of the current scheduled window, which would obviously impact the quality of it, and with that, potential sponsorships pulling out of the Currie Cup. So a loss that they need to try and get right if the Currie Cup is to survive in the modern rugby climate in South Africa. Before we look at this, please do smash like on the video. Please do subscribe to the channel as well. Right, so we've known that there is currently a big clash between the South African Rugby, so the South African Players Association, sort of my players, and South African Rugby over the current scheduling of the domestic rugby, with the rugby calendar not allowing for what is supposed to be a mandatory 8-week break for players at unions and also the contracted players. So basically, there is an arbiter who has ruled, or an arbitration verdict rather, that announced on Monday evening that all provincial players, including those from Stormers, Bulls, Lions and Sharks, must have an uninterrupted rest period of 8 weeks every 12 months. This is obviously an issue given the fact that the rugby calendar at the moment does not allow for an 8-week break because the Currie Cup is set to take place in July. So in terms of provincial players, if they were to finish end of June and they then had July, August off and they started again in September, that would allow for 8 weeks. Now, not all players are differently. Obviously, you've got Springboks involved there. You've got players in the provincial unions playing URC as opposed to Currie Cup and stuff like that. But there needs to be an uninterrupted 8-week period, apparently. So where you can sort of rest players, obviously you can sort of change on what's going on in terms of with regards to when players rest. And you can say, right, this guy's going to get a rest from now until here or whatever. But apparently this is what needs to happen over here. So the SA Players Association basically asked the arbitrator to rule on a clause in the Players Collective Agreement, which is basically rules applying to all players contracted by South African unions, which includes the Springboks, and must happen at the same time, apparently. So SA Rugby now has to decide what to do, whether to go ahead or whether not to go ahead with the Currie Cup, which is, as I said, supposed to take place from July until August. Apparently, my players, or players, or the players' organization, my players, are happy to go ahead with the Currie Cup as planned, but if there is an 8-week rest period for all provincial players later in the year. There is no time for this, because this now impacts the URC calendar, which has already been confirmed, by the way, which is scheduled to start on the 20th of September. So you've now got to look at where do they give players different times to rest. And again, you don't have to rest the entire squad. So you could, for example, say, right, okay, so the Lions, for example, their non-Springbok players, for example, if they are going to have Springbok players, they now finished this last week. So if you're looking for 8 weeks now, an uninterrupted period now, you can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. They could basically start playing right beginning from sort of second week of August. So they could then say, all right, cool, all of those guys are going to go on rest. And we're going to start the Currie Cup with our younger team, you know, with our sort of players who haven't played in a certain amount of rugby, for example, and stuff like that. And I think that's also, for me, what needs to be quite important is the fact that not all players have played the same sort of game time, for example. There's obviously injuries for me that need to be sort of factored in and stuff like that. I don't know whether sort of injuries we have counted race periods, but for me, I think it's not as simple as just sort of saying, obviously, 8 weeks, uninterrupted, that's the idea, but there needs to be sort of a, for me, again, you know, the science obviously is very different, but probably need to look at things like game time, how much have they played, you know, because I think, you know, players playing week in, week out, 80 minutes, you know, training, 80 minutes for training, is very different to a squad player who's training 2-3 times a week, but not playing on the weekends. So, yeah, but either way, so that's the issue. So if they were to play the Currie Cup and all these players were to play, then they've got to find 8 weeks to rest players. So this becomes a very big juggling act for the unions. And this is where depth's going to become a thing because, again, you know, if you are a Stormers or a Bulls and you get to the final 22nd of June, 8 weeks on the 22nd of June basically rules them out from charge of the Currie Cup. Because you'll be looking at, I mean, 8 weeks on the 22nd of June, maybe 29th. One, three, four, five, six, seven. They basically only started their play in the last week of August. So they've missed a big bulk of the Currie Cup. I think obviously that's when you look at the Currie Cup format. You know, how many matches do you need to get in, for example? You know, if it's a 7-week tournament, an 8-week tournament, we're talking about a 12-week tournament. I think for me, you probably need to try and compact as much as you can. I know that you don't really want to. The idea of home and away is very nice. But maybe it's one of those things you got to relook at the format and say, right, 8 teams, one game each, 7 games in 7 weeks, semi-finals. It's a 9-week tournament, starts in mid-July and, you know, finishes in September just before the other season starts. And you can then try and, you know, if you go far in the URC, unfortunately, you have to rest your players. And it's kind of one of those things that is the reality. The problem is, obviously, and this is the problem with sponsors, is that they want to sponsor a good product. And if you've got all the players resting, you don't have your best players involved, they're not going to sponsor that product. You know, they want to sponsor a product which sees Springboks playing, you know, or Springbok cap players playing, you know, the exciting youngsters playing. They want to see strong caliber rugby in the Currie Cup if they are to then put their financial backing behind it. So it's a bit of a catch-22 where I think, you know, SA Rugby is adamant that the Currie Cup will have to continue. But given the fact that there has been this ruling that they need to have 8 weeks uninterrupted rest, how does that work? You know, do they then, for example, play certain players and almost sort of split the squad approach, you know, and say, right, we're going to play, you know, play a semi-strength, full-strength squad. Some of these players are not going to get their rest now. They're going to get their rest in August, September, October, for example, or mid-August to mid-October, and say, cool, we'll leave them out the first three games of the URC, and, you know, that'll be their rest period. So it becomes a bit of a balancing act. And obviously, when Springbok players start playing, the Springboks, then that becomes even more difficult because then, you know, again, our season finishes now, and then there's the Inter-Island Internationals, but then we still play in August, whereas, for example, your Northern Hemisphere sides, they don't play in August at all into the Internationals, and, you know, you still start mid-September, and generally a lot of those Internationals not play until about October, so they'll have that time, that if we can uninterrupted to rest. So, very difficult situation. What do you think should happen? Let me know down in the comments below. Please do smash the like on the video and subscribe to the channel as well. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Steve. I'll chat to you soon.